unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say of this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you.
Verse 21.
How be it this time goeth not out but by prayer and fasting?
There's some demons that you cannot deal with except by fasting and praying.
Yes.
And what you do in fasting and praying, that's why it's a fasting and praying ministry. Amen. That's why the food you got is Gatorade and water. Amen. And it's something that don't taste good. Amen. Amen. Some of y'all want something else. Amen. That'll happen tomorrow at 12. I'm praying and I'm blessing you to understand the significance and the power of fasting and praying, because it can change your life. Now listen to this, y'all. This is important. This is very important. Every one of y'all that's in here have a special calling on his life.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to go deeper than that. The scriptures say many are called, but few are chosen.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Every one of y'all have been called, but you've been chosen as well.
All right.
God has called you.
Yeah, preacher, speak.
To do a greater work.
Yes.
Have an individual calling with you. He didn't talk to you on the side. But the calling became greater because now you're chosen to do a great work.
Yeah.
Thank you, J.Y. I love what you did. J.Y. made it clear that his whole family was drinking. Uh-huh. Wow. But God called him out, listen to this, y'all, with a 7-year-old girl. Somebody gonna get that. With a 7-year-old. 7 is the number of completion. Bible says a child will lead you.
That's what it says.
All right.
That's what it says.
Can I help somebody?
Oh.
His baby.
Yep.
Opened his eyes.
Yes, sir.
Then he made it clear that after that happened, it didn't just stop just like that.
Amen.
Sometimes there's a fight that's going on.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Satan won't let go of you. And listen to this. The reason he won't let go of you, because he knows J.Y. was going to help the whole family.
Yeah.
And if somebody is here, Lord have mercy. The main reason Satan was trying to stop Peter had nothing to do with Peter. It was all up when Peter preached his first sermon. Oh, look, somebody going to get this, amen. Some things don't come except by fasting and praying.
Yeah.
Now let's deal with this, because I don't need you to do any kind of fast. Because Isaiah 58 talks about the correct fast and talks about the wrong fast.
Go ahead, then. All right.
Because I need you to get involved and say, cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgressions in the house of Jacob their sin. See, God ain't gonna keep beating you over your head with your sins unless you decide to ask God to show you your stuff.
Amen.
All right.
You gotta say, God, I'm a sinner.
Yeah.
But it happens. Listen to this. If you keep doing the same old thing, you will get the same old results.
Yeah, you will.
But if you want to change, you gotta do some new thing. The Bible says, take off your old man and put on your new man. So they got to be achieved. See, I have a problem. I sit there with the Lord and say, Lord, show me my sins.
All right.
Then when you show them to me, I ask God to change me from my sins.
Amen.
Because we pray a prayer, J.Y., that always got me. Say, God, forgive me for my sins, known and unknown. I said, how I got unknown sins? How I got sins? I try to control. wanted to know the history.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, you're okay. Anybody in your family ever had kids?
Yeah.
Anybody in your family ever had high blood pressure?
Yeah.
They start asking me these questions. They have to answer. Did I help somebody? The doctors even know. Yeah. Oh, you had cancer. And because you had cancer, they want to make sure they start checking on your body to make sure if cancer show up, we already ahead of it because they are not even they got a knowledge.
Yeah.
Spiritual people of God.
Come on now.
Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed. How? By the renewing of yo, mind.
Yeah, man.
Pastor Watson, I ain't got time for this foolishness, man. That T-bone steak look good, shucks. Pastor Watson, are you serious?
Yeah.
You need to learn the power of fasting and praying.
All right.
You can change your life, your family member's life, but let me help you, it's going to be a battle. See, cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins.
Yes.
Preacher, Sunday after Sunday, you ain't like you won't hear them anyway. Mm-hmm. Yet, they seek me daily, listen to this, y'all, and delight to know my ways as a nation that did righteousness, and forsook not my ordinance for their God. They ask of me the ordinance of justice. They take delight in approach to God. Wherefore have we fasted, said them, and thou seest not? Wherefore have we afflicted our soul, and thou takest no knowledge? Behold, in the days you fast, you find pleasure and exact all labor. Behold, you fast for strife and debate, and smite the fist of wickedness. Ye shall not fast as you do this day, to make your voice to be heard on high. Listen to this, y'all. It is such a fast that I have chosen, a day for a man to afflict his soul. It is to bow down his head as bulrush and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him. Will not call this a fast, an acceptable fast of the Lord? You see, we can fast for all wrong reasons. Somebody can fast just because they want to speak. And God will give them that power and reference then. But when you want to break some yokes,
yeah,
it got to be an acceptable fast of the Lord.
Yes.
Can I deal with you? There's some people in the Bible that fell into an acceptable fast of the Lord and wasn't even planning. Saul was on his way on Damascus Road to take Christians and imprison.
Wow.
God knocked him off his beast. Anybody read it beside me?
Yeah.
But it was unfortunate that it said that Saul didn't eat nothing.
Yeah, he
went on a fast and didn't even know he was on a fast.
Wow.
And that's what God does sometimes, to change us, to take off the old man and put on new. And that Paul, I mean that Saul became, I said it wrong, Saul was on the beast. I didn't get it right, I apologize. Next thing you know, there was a transition from Saul to Paul.
Yeah.
And in my opinion, I felt that Saul always knew who God was. Check this out. After he knocked him off the peace, he had the audacity to ask, God, is that you? When I read that, I said, he already knew who he was. He was like some people just acting like it. Yeah, that's what the other man knows. But the transition,
yeah,
comes in fasting and praying.
All right.
The change comes in fasting and praying. And you got some of us in here that's dealing with the curse right now.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
Let's go a little further. But this is where I really get that from. This is where I really get that from. Verse number 6 says, is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the band of wickedness, to undo the heavy burden, to let the oppressed go free, that ye break every yoke. Can I deal with this for just a second?
It ain't gonna take me long. Yeah, that's for you. Yeah, that's for you. Yeah, that's for you.
I gotta make sure you get this. Because somebody called me sleep. But you gonna get me to before the day over. Somebody in your time. Y'all been up all day. Some of y'all were at work today. Y'all tired. Y'all gonna get this, amen. I ain't letting you leave without this, amen. I ain't letting you walk out of here without a clear understanding about this curse thing, amen.
My Lord.
I researched Daddy, I found out Daddy was my problem. I even went talking to Eddie. Eddie said, boy, that's the best woman I ever had. He said, the rest of the women, all they wanted to do was take my money. He said, your mama made sure I had money, she had money, and we all got something. He said, I got more calls than I ever had before in my life. Yeah. Yeah. So he understood.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. He understood. Then I had something to do. I got to do something. So y'all, I just start talking to the Lord. Come on, I'm going to really break this thing out here. I start talking to the Lord. Lord, I don't want to be like this.
All right.
Oh. Lord, I don't want to be like this. Yeah. I need help from you. The Lord said, are you serious? I said, yeah, I'm serious, you know. See, the fasting and praying comes. The Lord told me one day, go in there and make a loan. Well, faith see the credit union. Now I know I got bad credit. But the Lord said, look, I walked in there and told him I need a loan. He said, how much? I said, $1,000. The woman looked at my credit score and said, oh, can you do? I walked away. I said, Lord, you told me to go in here. He said, I ain't take that for $1,000. So I went back. Don't have that again. Don't have that again. This is a true story. I went back and I asked for $500 and the lady said, oh, not $500. My consistency of what the Lord, because he told me to go ask, I know I heard his voice. I said, can I get $100? She said, yeah. Now, knowing what God was doing and what he had told me, at that time, they didn't put it on a debit card.
All
right. It was cash money.
All right.
So when they gave you cash, I rolled it up and put it in the back of my wallet. You hear me? Mm-hmm. And 29 days later, I went and paid that loan off. Yeah. Listen to this, y'all, because y'all need to hear this. After I paid the loan off, the Lord said, go get another loan. Well, I paid off $100, y'all, so I'm walking out. I'm pretty big now, you know. So I asked for $300. She looked at me, she gave me $300.
Right.
And the same thing. Put it back in my wallet. Some of you hear what I'm saying. Yeah, put it in the corner of my wallet. 29 days later, I came and paid off the $300. I'm walking down there. I waited a while, so you just calm down. I came back. I got the paperwork to show you. I checked this stuff to remind myself how good and how awesome God is. Came back. See the Bible, y'all. as a child. And she did a hit and gone with it. So I got older. Doing the same thing. Me and Crown Royal were having fun. Yeah. I decided one day I wanted to quit. Well, that thing was in my spirit, man. You couldn't just quit just like that.
Yeah.
I went cold turkey for a whole year, y'all.
Wow, just say.
And they came around and had a party. Lord have mercy. The party was over with, amen. I broke it.
Yeah.
Then after that, 6 months later, I embarrassed myself in someone's house on the bathroom floor. I'm laying in that toilet room. And when I walked out of there, y'all listen to this. I walked with my hands in the sky and said, Lord, I don't want none. Take this out of my system.
Yeah, man.
It had been over 23 years.
Thank you,
God. Since I had
it. Thank you.
I got so bad in my early stages, y'all. Listen to this. In my early stages of quitting the drink, the last time when I raised my hand, you got to admit it, you got to believe it, you got to confess it. God, we got to know I had a problem. I stood there with my hands up and started crying. In my early stages, y'all need to hear this. It ain't been no more than 6 months since I quit. I go to a football game and I'm sitting in the bleachers. And there's somebody about 3 or 4 rows down for me drinking Crown Royal. And Fred, I smell it.
Yeah, yeah.
I had to get my son to leave. You know why I left? I went under the bridges and throw it up.
Oh, wow.
The same thing I drunk, Crown Royal, straight up on the rocks. Now I can't stand the smell.
Not
a lot. That's what kind of deliverance power.
Yeah.
Fasting and praying will do in your life.
Let's go real quick. Let's go real quick. There's somebody else in need got it to. But I want you to know I'm fast.
Verse number 7 says, it's not to deal the bread to the hungry, wrong fast, and that thou bring the poor that are cast out to the house, that wrong fast, when thou seest the naked, that thy clothing, and that thou hide not thyself from thine own flesh. It's not fast, but this is. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning.
My Lord, then.
Then shall thy light break forth. And your gift is not mine.
My Lord.
And then right here. Your gift is not mine.
Yeah.
It's when you make up your mind that you're sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Yeah.
That you make up your mind that you're tired of being a fool.
Yeah.
Yeah. When you make up your mind, that it might be your 7-year-old that comes off to you. Yeah. And the 7 is a number of completion and somebody that needs to be broken. I don't know, it said, then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy help shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee, and the glory of the Lord shall be thy. I like that, it doesn't say reward, it says re-reward.
All right.
I've been trying to reward you all a while, amen, but you wasn't getting it, amen.
Some shackles just like he did on Paul and Silas.
Verse 9 says, then shall thy call, and the Lord shall answer. Thou shalt cry, and he shall say, here am I. If thou have taken away from the midst of thee the yoke, and put it before the offender, and speaking vanity, this ain't about materialistic things. This is God, if you need to bless somebody else, and if you bless somebody else, God gonna take care of you.
Yeah, man.
Now, this is the real one, because I got a lot of fasting and praying buddies in here. Amen. And the thing is, we fast for other people. Mm-hmm. It ain't always about you. Mm-hmm. Amen. On my 39th birthday, I was sick and tired of my oldest brother. He had been on drugs for over 30 years. Wow. Crack cocaine, marijuana. He was the person that introduced me to drugs. Scared me half the day. Thank God I had a horrible experience with that. Man, that was not a long career for me. get me. So I got on the phone. Y'all need to hear this. I called my mom. She bless her heart. I said, Mom, we got to do something about my older brother. And she said, what you want to do? I said, I want to fast 3 weeks. From 12 midnight to 12 midnight. And I'm going to tell y'all, my thing of 12 is the Bible. It's biblical. Paul and Silas broke at 12, so why I can't do 12 then?
Okay? All right.
Yeah. So from 12 midnight to 12 midnight, we fast and prayed for a whole year. Every Wednesday. 52 weeks. Oldest brother didn't know nothing but it. I called my mama and I called my two brothers. That was four of us. Fasting and praying. Yeah. Oldest brother didn't know nothing about it. The fast was over. My brother woke up one morning, took the crack pipe and put it down. And he'd been drug free for 17 years.
My Lord.
All right.
And he didn't find out until 5 years later that we were fasting and praying. And if somebody that God want to use in this room,
my Lord.
It's all right.
Call. Yes. And chose.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Somebody in here. Yeah. Verse 9, when we did it again, then shall I call. And the Lord shall answer.
Yeah.
Thou shalt cry, and he shall say, hear my.
And I knew when I picked my mama, and my mama loved her sons. I knew my mama would be faithful in this fasting. I found out years later after my mama passed, she told my auntie that I was crazy. She said, that little friend called me talking about fasting for theater, baby. She said,
Romans 8 chapter, verse number 14. Romans 8, chapter 1, verse 14. When this thing line you up with the Spirit of God, it will change your life. For many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
Yes, sir.
For if ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby ye cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. I got you there? Because this fasting brings your spirit and God's spirit on the same level.
Yeah.
Okay, but verse 17 is where the blessing comes. And if ye children, then heirs of God. Heirs mean that you get some of God's stuff. We're going to go back and deal with that. And joint heir with Christ. Joint heir means you get some of Christ's stuff. And if so be it that we suffer. And you see, that's the thing. None of us really want suffering. We want water to, we want to be blessed, we want and this thing is about going through it sometime to get to it.
Amen, man.
Amen. This is about making a sacrifice, amen.
Yeah.
This is about, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Yes.
And if children did heir of God and joy of Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified to justice. And there's some blessings God had me right here on earth. It got real quiet. Mm-hmm. Right here on earth.
Yeah.
We're listening, but some people get scared too, but that's okay. Mm-hmm. Amen. It just ain't no diet. Because sometimes I'm on my path, but back to the bigger I kill, I'm confused by that. But that's confusing. Being God is not an author of confusion. So a part of that fast, he said, heal my body, amen. So, whoa, I hear you, Lord. I hear you. So a part of that is I got to be healthy, amen.
Yes.
Amen. He wants the world to see that I'm healthy, amen. Thank you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, amen. Somebody in here. Come on, let's go to Isaiah 58. We're almost in for this. We're almost in for this. Yeah. Let me make sure this is another part. Fasting will heal your body. Fasting will heal your body. Okay. If you sick and you got problems, you finally start fasting. Back to that person. And I probably some of y'all have heard it before, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. My dad used to always have stomach problems. And he used to make this device. And I always seen the movie before, Wallace, the old doctor, and he used to have a bowl, and all the smoke would be coming up from the bowl. And my daddy said, get some hot water, get some vinegar, and get some soda. The contraction used to be. And you pour that stuff in there, and pray that would be bubbling up. But if you drink it, it will calm down the stomach. Okay? And I said, I was going to stop doing that. I went to a doctor, and the doctor ran all kinds of tests and couldn't find out what was wrong. Oh, Lord. I wasn't into physical and spiritual things, but I was into fasting at that time. The doctor said, he's going to freeze the spot on my stomach, dig in and pull a piece out, and he's going to study it. I said, yeah, you can do that next time I come. A bird text out, never did show up. I never did go. You ain't freezing them spots. I don't know what you call it. You ran all these tests and ain't working. That ain't gonna happen. So next time you come. But at that time, I decided it was time for me to fast and pray.
All right.
And this is a JY situation here. And I've been fasting and praying for a while. My family comes to my house. Houston, my daddy's stomach started bothering me, and he said, you ain't got no soda and vinegar? And I said, no, sir. He said, what you mean you ain't got no soda and vinegar? My baby brother, he's a preacher at that time. He said, you ain't got no soda? I said, no, I've been fasting. My daddy didn't fast, but my baby brother showed up. You've been fasting? And I said, yeah, I've been fasting. My baby brother said, okay. He starts screaming. My baby brother seen what was going on with me. He started fasting and praying. His stomach got healed. And my daddy's still over there trying to figure out what's going on. But in the name of Jesus, somebody got to understand, God will show you. And he, it's right there in the scripture. You see your help. It's right there. It's right there. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy help shall spring forth speedily. And thy righteousness shall go before thee. And the glory of the Lord shall be thine. I like that. Read me more. Read me more. Can I deal with that, y'all? I know y'all have issues, but I'm going to deal with it because y'all have money. Amen. There's a part of the Bible that God said he will bless us with his good treasures. So there, treasures for me are already good. I look at the poverty pictures, and I see treasures, and treasures are good. You gonna bless me with your good treasures? Why? What's your good treasure look like? I'm gonna shut up again, no, amen. But I see them coming to me every day, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Right.
Amen. I see them coming every day.
First, let me let the Lord shall guide thee continuously. And satisfy thy soul in the drug, and make fat thy bone, and thou shalt be like a water garden, and like a spring of water whose water faileth not. God will bless you, but you got to be willing to back up from the physical table and pull up to the spiritual table. Now, pulling up to the spiritual table is not just fasting, it's fasting and praying. And as you fast and pray, God will bring you down into his word. He's going to reveal some things to you that you probably never seen nor never heard before. He gonna take some old scriptures to bless you in a mighty way. One of the ones he took to me and really turned me upside down. A one that all y'all know real good. The 23rd number Psalm. And when he flipped that thing on me, Pastor Jones, I ain't never been seen. He said, the Lord is my shepherd.
That's right.
I shall not want.
Right.
Then he backed up and said, do you want anything? And he said, oh, shucks. He said, you're not letting me shepherd you. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. I've been reading that thing all my life. It ain't never said that, J.Y. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. And he asked me, do I want anything? And I said, yeah. And he said, you ain't letting me shepherd you. So, Lord, have mercy. That's okay. Y'all don't need it before y'all go home. Amen. And there's somebody in here, amen. Verse 21, and they shall be this is why I call you called and chosen. And they that shall be of thee shall build the old wasteland. Thou shalt rise up the foundation of many generations, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach. The restorer of the path to the wilderness.
Yeah.
There's a reason that a whole bunch of people ain't here. Amen.
Yeah.
But there's a reason that you here.
You.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a reason that you here. Amen.
Yeah.
Everybody ain't concerned about everybody else. Some people just me, myself, and I. But God wants some men that are concerned about more than me, myself, and I.
Hello.
And let me help you, somebody can get mad. He ain't necessarily want the one to go out there and get up. 45 to go fight with somebody. He wants somebody to come together as a group, fasting and praying, casting out demons, turning people around. Jesus always sent the disciples out in twos.
Yeah.
He wants a group of people. My mom passed away. I was looking for a prayer boy to pray with me. And a whole bunch of them came and a whole bunch of them listened. You don't hear what I'm saying. But almost 10 years later, the Lord sent the one. And I can guarantee at 12 noon, we're going to pray every day. And this is bad, but he blind. God had sent me a blind man. Because the one that just, and he may be blind physical, but he can see some of the spirit.
My Lord. My Lord.
And the biggest thing is in this day and time, everything is quick, fast, and hurry. Nobody can wait on the Lord. I'm saying it and I'll say it again just for the fun of it, amen. You know you got set up when somebody give you a car that got 120 miles an hour on the speedometer. And the highest you can go
get 65. That's a setup. Somebody did that way home. That's a setup. Yeah. Yeah, they waiting for you to set that stuff, amen. Why do you put all this on here? And there is nowhere in the United States that we can go 120 miles an hour on a racetrack and you put it on a mama. Why? That's okay, I'm gonna get low. Everybody trying to get you to hurry up about everything. You stick your food in the microwave, amen. 5 minutes is done, amen. You try that foolishness. You go home and try to cook some chicken in 5 minutes of grease, and you got blood and everything else dripping all out of it. In the name of somebody out here, and the Lord said, they that wait upon the Lord. I'm trying to help somebody. The Lord will make you all in a hurry.
My Lord.
Man.
My technology. I can see something in Los Angeles right now.
All right.
Yeah, modern technology, live in Los Angeles. But I tell you one thing, you can't go to Los Angeles as quick as I can see it.
All right.
Amen? We need to make sure that we wait on God. Verse 13 says, if thou turn away thy foot, this is important, y'all, from the Sabbath, from doing thy pleasures on my holy day, thank J.Y., because that was my problem too. I wanted to see a football game on Sunday. And call the Sabbath delight. Holy is the Lord, honorable, and shall honor him, not doing thy own ways, nor finding thy own pleasure, nor speaking thy own words. It ain't about none of us in here. It's all about Jesus Christ. How he wants to use you, how he wants to bless you, how he wants to change.
Yeah.
But in the process of all that, y'all need to hear this. You got to make sure you give the glory to God.
My Lord.
When God uses you, don't be sticking your chest out because it ain't you. God uses you to preach a good sermon. You got your chest stuck out like you did something. You ain't did nothing.
Yeah.
God gave you that, amen.
Yeah.
You say something encouraging to help somebody and you got your, you ain't did nothing. Oh. You got to give the glory to God.
Yeah.
He's the glory giver.
Yeah.
And you got to give him the glory because he will use you to create miracles that you ain't never seen before.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Fasting and praying is a very powerful tool that if you use it, it can bless you.
Yeah.
It can change
you. Yeah.
All throughout the Bible. Nineveh. Did I tell you a story about Nineveh?
My Lord.
Jesus was in a position that he was getting ready to destroy Nineveh. But everybody fasted and prayed. Now look how God made everybody. They made sure the cattle didn't get the food. The cattle didn't get enough to eat. Nobody fasted and prayed for four days. Amen.
Yeah.
That's a serious fast, eh? That's a serious fast. Jesus himself asked for 40 days and 40 nights, and at the end of that, if anybody paid attention, there's always something phenomenal that happens at the end of a fast. The Bible said the angels came to minister to him. Wow. That blew my mind.
Yeah.
And God is waiting for people. He's waiting on you to break some of your generational curses in your life right now. But it's on you.
Yeah.
It's on you. You gotta say enough is enough. This was not an easy men retreat to put together. Because I fought all kinds of battles in this one. But I knew it and I understood it.
All
right. I had all kinds of demons attacked in this one. But I knew it, John Turner, and I understood it.
Yeah.
And J.Y., just like you, I've been waiting on this one for a while. When Pastor Jones called me and talked about a retreat, I think Roger was right with me that day. I got all excited. But he said a men to boys. He didn't know what I was thinking. I was thinking a men to men. Man, I didn't tell him across the phone. I wanted to sit down and talk to him one-on-one. When I told him one-on-one, he said, oh, yeah. I said, oh, we in trouble now. Yeah, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said, gave you this. That didn't make no sense to me. Mm. You live somebody give you business that's not making no money. Somebody gave you a business.
Yeah.
Called me and said, come check this out. I went checked it out. When they got through, they said, do you want this business? I said, what did he say? And all the money I seen go across the table. What is, do you want what? So they don't know, Roberto knows. Fasting and praying will change your whole lifestyle. Somebody in you.
Wow.
That God is speaking to me. Verse 14. Then shall I delight myself in the Lord, and I will cause you to ride upon the high places of the earth, and feed you with the heritage of Jacob, thy father. I like this last part more than anything. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. No.
God has spoken. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. So as I introduce you to fasting and praying, if you want to know about it, give me a call. I got some books on it. This, that, the other. I wanted to put a book in everybody's hand, but unfortunately I couldn't get the one I wanted to give you. But there's a lot of power in it. Me and Mike Madrano do some fasting and praying together. Amen. That's some of my prayer partners from GE. Amen. He used to sit there. I don't claim the fact that God blessed me to be there as long as I was there to come and stay over. Tell you what, I don't claim that. For sure, when I retire, for sure, close. When I retire, for sure, close the production department. Amen. The service was still open. They're more than less still praying. The service was still open. Like I said, amen. But the production department,
Wow.
The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So that meant every morning at GE, I was praying. I had some bosses in the beginning that were scared to tell me that anyway. At the end, I had some bosses and Michael made me laugh because they came and watched me while I was praying. And what I used to do, J.Y., I used to go pray on my break. So it really couldn't do nothing about it. And anybody know anything about me praying, I'm serious when I'm praying, so my eyes were closed. And Mike would tell me later on, your boss is standing right in front of you while you're praying.
Wow.
But it was my break. She couldn't do nothing. She couldn't do a thing about it. It was my break, bro. It was my break. It was my break. I was praying. And God, because it ain't me, y'all. I gotta hear it inside me. It's the Lord inside of me. The Lord pushing me. It's the Lord telling me. It's the Lord directing me. It's not Frank Watson III. Frank Watson III ain't got nothing to do with this. And guess what? He won't do even greater with you. But it's about obedience to what his voice is saying. And then you might not like to hear it, but he's gonna tell you to do something that's not really normal.
All right. Yeah. I hear you, Pastor.
Let me say it again. He gonna tell you to do something that's not really normal to everybody else, but it's really normal to him.
Yeah.
He said there's a straight and narrow path. Not too many go this way. Y'all need to pray for my wife, but I always got something going on. Yeah, bless her little heart. Yeah. Because the Lord speaks to me, she doesn't get to the point, she don't say nothing, no, let it go, let it go. You know, it's all me. Ain't gonna tell me what he's doing now, the Lord just says it, you know. And it ain't me. And you got some of the same men in here right now. Let me make sure I identify myself. I'm an ex-crown lord friend.
Alright.
Okay. I'm an ex-adulterer and fornicator. Ex, make sure you get an ex.
Alright.
Amen. I'll make sure that I used to lie so good, y'all, that I used to fool myself. I used to fool myself, y'all hear me talking? shucks, I would have released one of them. They ain't gonna tell what gonna happen after that. But God keep delivering me.
Yeah, man.
Because I keep bringing it to him. And he got some things. Thank God. I ain't got nothing new stuff in my closet. I got some.